You know, bedding is so very important, but sometimes it's overlooked. A lot of people think sheets are bedding. Sheets are just like underwear. The most important part is the clothing, what you see from the outside, not what you see from underneath, in my eyes. These feathers are perfect for the backboard. They add height and dimension. Heidi, will you proceed to bring all the pillows over? The more pillows, the merrier.
Is there a way that the average person can do this at home shopping at the Target?
Yes, luxurious sets of one-of-a-kind bedding might not be affordable to the masses. However, there are ways to step around that by choosing different edge detail, different fabric. I feel that the bedroom should pay homage to the owner of the home and should reflect that owner of that home. And what does your bedding say about yourself, Debbie?
Over the top.
I think it's over the top, glittery, and very sexy and warm, because you're probably a warm-hearted woman.
I really am.
And now you have a complete set of luxurious bedding. I like to help my customers feel good in bed.
Okay, so the bottom line is you can buy beads and lace and such and sew it onto a bedspread and have it look expensive for a fraction of the cost. Just takes a little time and creativity. Now, Bobby is known for his pillows, feathers, and such, so next Monday, Bobby and I will look at turning boring pillows into creative cushions. I'm Graham Ledger. Bobby Trendy, if you know that name, you probably watched, although you might not want to admit it, the Anna Nicole Smith television show. Bobby Trendy is the decorator to the stars in Hollywood. Well, he's also working his magic in San Diego County. And tonight, he shows me and you how to create his high-end interior designs on a budget. Which begs the question, can Bobby turn Graham trendy?
This extraordinary floral arrangement was ordered by a local florist here in Rancho Santa Fe, and it costed $300.
Not cheap, but it's beautiful.
Let me show you how to make this for about $45.
You're kidding. $45?
$45.
All right.
First thing we need.
So we're gonna make an arrangement here that looks like it costs $300-$400, but it's actually $45-$50.
Yeah, it could be $45 or $50. If you just look at the display, these greens right here are about $3 or $4 a bundle. These are about $6 or $7. This is $3. This is $3. This is about $5 for these orchids. What you wanna do is use a lot of greens because greens cost the least amount of money. I always love these little droopy things, drooping on the side just like jewelry.
Is this the technical term, droopy thing?
Yeah, droopy things. Right. That's what these are called because they droop.
They're going up.
They're going up.
To the ceiling, to the sky.
Everything is going up but the price. You just keep adding it in.
Can I do one?
Yes. Just stick it right in. Think tall and short. I just sit here and do this all day. Look at how gorgeous the spring arrangement is turning out to be. There you go. A beautiful floral arrangement for $45. And I chose volume instead of form here. I thought the more the merrier. And you know, a floral arrangement like this can really turn a dinner into an event.
Now, Bobby is known for his pillows, feathers, and such. So next Monday, Bobby and I will go to the bedroom and talk about bedding and how to turn the mundane into the marvelous and on a budget. I'm Graham Ledger. He's in Hollywood and he starred in the Anna Nicole Smith show. Tonight, though, he's helping you and me with some high-class, expensive-looking wall treatments that can be done on a budget. What are we looking at here? These are samples.
Yes, these are samples, Graham. More than often, our customers want to see wall fabrication samples before they order because some of them don't know what it is. This here is a padded wall where we would put foam on your walls on a frame and then we would pad it. This gives the feel and look of padding.
For people who don't really know, the idea behind doing the fabric on the wall is what? To give some dimension?
It is just a very luxurious method to do other than wallpaper or painting. When you do this method, it's all about fabric. You could use 1,000 yards in one room. So someone that would like to save money could use a cheaper fabric. Someone that does not want to save money could use a more expensive fabric.
This is the finished product.
Yes, this is a perfect example of a sheared wall. See how it's sheared and how beautiful and luxurious that is? A customer like this, where money is no object, we would shear, we would spend so much fabric in this room to give her the look that she really wants. Our customer's like, more is more.
If you wanted to try this at home, there are some pitfalls. You have to be very careful, correct?
Yes, if someone were to try this at home, they would staple foam onto this, and then the fabric on top of that, and then they would do a little welting like this with a staple gun.
But this look can be done at home.
This look can be done at home with some foam and a staple gun and some imagination.
That's all you need. Imagination is probably the toughest part to interior design for those of us who are creatively challenged. But I'll tell you, fabric on a wall like that can change the whole feel and look for any room, even a bathroom. There's much more news ahead. Local 8 News at 6:30 starts right now. Bobby Trendy is the decorator to the stars in Hollywood. He starred on the Anna Nicole Smith television show. Well, Bobby Trendy is now helping us in San Diego County decorate some really nice and expensive homes, but he's also helping those of us who also shop at Target decorate inexpensively. So tonight, he shows me and you how to create his high-end interior designs on a budget.
Debbie, you have such beautiful and exquisite sheets, but you know, this look here doesn't really reflect you. Let's turn these sheets from drab to fab.
Okay, let's do it.
Let's do it. I want it to be of museum quality. Debbie wants feathers. She has feathers. Less is never more in my book. It should always be more is more.
And it just happens to be for sale, Graham.
That's right, if you can afford $24 million. Now, this doesn't happen very often on Local 8 News. First off, right away, here's a retraction and correction. I believe we say this house is a shoe closet that holds about 300 shoes. Well, that's not correct. It holds 500 shoes. There, the record's straight. There you go, Imelda. Now on with the tour. This is the biggest and most expensive house in San Diego County. Tell me about it.
It's almost 7 acres, and it's in prime Covenant Acres, which is important, and very private.
I mean, this has the Bellagio feel to it, the marble, the high, high ceilings.
It does. It's probably even prettier than the Bellagio. The main house is 17,000 square feet.
Right.
And under roof, 26,000 square feet.
26,000. Are you sure about that?
Let's measure it.
Let's measure it.
Okay.
Come on, let's go.
Every tile and marble has been imported.
All right, let's see the west wing.
Let's see the west wing.
What do we have?
We have the bar right here. We have the pool table on this side. And this is the room you really want to see.
That's beautiful. What do we call
this? We call this the playroom. Here. We can show movies here.
Uh-huh. All right.
And we have 50 speakers here. Okay. This is more than a master suite. This four-poster bed includes surround sound system inside. And at the push of a button, the TV will come up.
Oh, let me do this. Okay, will you hold it?
So.
All right, what do you got there?
We're in the master wing, and this is the most incredible master bath, including a double master bathtub,
wow,
a beautiful etching, and the walk-in shower. A shoe closet, which holds 300 pairs of shoes.
Now, we have to imagine this full of clothes, because this room and that room is about as big as a lot of people's apartments.
Absolutely. On this part of the wing, we have the private gym.
Ah, let's go for a little workout.
Okay? All right, let's do it. This is the private gym, which includes his and her sunning beds.
Free weights.
Free weights. Steam room. 14 feet, 6 inches.
All right, that's for the pantry.
That's for the pantry.
That's a lot of chicken helper.
Quite a bit of chicken helper.
Let's see the kitchen. Huh?
Let's go to the kitchen.
All right, what do we have?
The delightful kitchen has dual everything. Dishwashers, dual Sub-Zeros, dual microwave ovens.
Dual sinks.
Dual sinks.
It looks like a Marriott out there.
It's designed like a resort out of Hawaii.
The fake alligator.
The fake alligator.
I mean, the animals, there's a menagerie out here, and there's a water slide.
There is, and there's the elephant right on top there.
Who do you envision buying a property like this?
I see someone, first of all, who's really a party person, who likes to entertain and have friends. And I see a definitely a Hollywood type.
And has a couple of bucks in the bank?
A few, yes.
6 feet, 4 inches. By my calculation, that's about 25,000 square feet. So what happened to the other 1,000?
Well, we haven't gone to the guest house yet.
Oh, the guest house. Let's go see it.
Let's do it.
Guest house. So. There you have it. If you want to see more, you can go to our website at KFMB.com and click on websites mentioned on the air, because we did not show you even 60% of that house. We didn't have time.
I'm telling you, what is the price tag on something like that?
It's $24 million. And if you think about financing, if you put about 20% right. down on $24 million, then you carry about a $19 million loan, 6%, that's about $130,000 a month payment.
Oh, is that all?
My
you can cover that.
Will they take a post-dated check?
I think.
That's post-dated way down
there. You know, it's a beautiful,
no
beautiful,
kidding. You were right. It does look like some kind of hotel resort.
Splendor in the Ranch, as they call it.
Room for kids.
Yeah.
I almost have enough shoes.